Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. We are going to continue with the Vishnu Sahasranam playlist, and we have started with Bhishma Pitama's speech. And in the last verse, we saw this shloka: Anadinidhanam Vishnum Sarva Loka Maheshwaram Lokadhyaksham Stubam Nityam Sarva Dukhati Govet. So I'll repeat the translation from the last shloka. There was never a time when Lord Vishnu first came into existence, and there is no time in the future when he will cease to exist. He is the supreme master of all planets, all living entities, and all the demigods who control the universe. He is all pervading, all knowing witness who sees everything. A person who regularly glorifies him becomes free of all material miseries, and in that liberated condition becomes full of transcendental bliss. And we also saw two slokas quoted by a famous acharya known as Baldev Vidyabhushan, where he spoke about the greatness of Lord Vishnu's name, holy name. If one chants the two syllables Hari even once, he becomes free from all material bondage. O best of the Bhrigu dynasty, if one even once speaks the holy name of Lord Krishna, either with faith or even casually or with contempt, the holy name will liberate that chanter from all material bondage, right? So Bhishma Pitama is speaking these verses, and now we will discuss the next verse, which is a very beautiful verse, as every verse. Brahmanyam sarva dharmanyam lokanam kirti vardhanam lokanatham mahadbhutam sarva bhuta bhavodbhavam. So again, this dharmagyam vardhanam bhavod bhavam bhutam, this is used always. This is very frequently used in Vedic scriptures, okay, the word dharmagyam, okay, sarva dharmagyam. So what is the translation to this verse? Lord Vishnu is the protector of the brahmanas and well-wisher of the brahmanas. Brahmanyam sarva dharmagyam. Aware of all principles of religion, sarva dharmagyam. Dharmagya means one who knows dharma. So sarva dharmagyam means one who knows all the religious principles. Lokanam kirti vardhanam. Okay, one who expands the glory of his devotees. The supreme monarch of all planetary systems. Where is this coming from? Lokanatham Mahadbhutam. Lokanath. Okay. Lokanath also means the master of all lokas, actually. Okay. Or it can mean the master of all humans or people. Lok can mean human beings or any living being in general, or it can mean the planetary systems also. Okay. So this Lokanatham has many meanings. Okay. Full of all opulences. Mahadbhutam. Mahadbhutam means full of all opulences, and the original father of Brahma, Shiva and all entities. Sarva Bhuta Bhavod Bhavam. Very beautiful shloka this is. So why does it say he is the protector and well-wisher of the Brahmanas, aware of all principles of religion, and the one who expands the glory of his devotees? Protector and well-wisher of all the Brahmanas. Now, does it mean he only protects the Brahmins? He doesn't protect the others like Kshatriyas or Vaishyas or Shudras? No, it's all like that. He protects everybody, but he's specially the well-wisher of the Brahmins. Okay. Now, why? Why? Is many times people think Vishnu is always partial to the Devatas or to the Brahmins. Actually, that's not partiality. That is like, see, imagine there's a classroom where there are 50 students, okay? And there is one student who is very sincere, very nice, who is very respectful, who always does the homework, who listens properly, who does what the teacher says. So therefore, and then imagine there are some other 5-10 students who never listen to the teacher, they never do the homework, they never study, they are always very insincere, they never come to the class. Okay, so now it is by default, it is but natural that this teacher will have more affection and love for this sincere student, because this student is doing his or her responsibility properly. So that creates this special relationship. So similarly, we see Arjuna was also the favorite disciple of Drona. So many times people accuse Dronacharya of doing partiality, why he was partial towards the towards Arjuna or towards the Pandavas, or why he was not equally disposed towards the Kurus, the Kauravas. Well, that's not partiality, because they were the Pandavas, especially headed by Yudhishthir, then Bhim, Arjuna, Kul Sahadev. Now, Arjuna is very special, that's different, but I'm talking of the Pandavas in general here. They were very good by nature. They were Dharmagya, again here. So they were Dharmagya, which means they knew Dharma, Dharma Parayan, right? They followed what Dharma, what they knew actually, okay? The religious principles, they were very kind, they were respectful, they were courteous, they were obedient, they were humble, they were all the good qualities they had actually. So any teacher, anybody would actually like these people. Now, liking them doesn't mean you do not pay attention to the others, all right? But those who are doing their duty properly, they deserve to be loved more and cherished more, okay? And therefore, the Brahmanas who... Now, who is a Brahmin here? Now, many times people think that, oh, this is referring to the caste system in India, okay, which is prevalent. Or not, may not be now, but it was always prevalent. So what does it mean when it says that Vishnu is disposed to the Brahmins? Brahmin doesn't mean one who is born in a Bharadwaj family or Goswami family or some Brahmin family, okay, religion-wise or caste-wise. Brahmana is defined by this definition, Brahma janeti iti Brahmin. So Brahma means God. So a person born in a Muslim family can also be a Brahmin, okay. A person born in a Christian family, a person born in a Vaishya family. Vaishya means the businessman, okay? The money related, the class which deals with money and bank, accounts, finance, they can also be a Brahmin, or a Kshatriya who is a leader or a king or a politician, if they are having the knowledge of God. So having knowledge doesn't mean just they know what God, I mean, about spiritual stuff, but they also follow, they lead a life which is conducive for spiritual elevation. So that is the definition of a Brahman, okay? Brahma janeti iti Brahmin, this shloka is there, it's very famous. So therefore, anybody who is trying to go ahead in their spiritual journey, or who has at least started, or one who is at least aware of spiritual truths and is ready to follow the spiritual path, principles lined in these scriptures, that person is a Brahmana, right? Either person is a male or a female or young or old, doesn't matter. Okay, so just because somebody is born in a Brahmana family, somebody has a title called Sharma or Goswami or Bharadwaj, it does not make them a Brahmin, right? Because Krishna says in Gita, Chatur Varnyam Maya System Guna Karma Vibhagasha, means I have created these four castes based on Guna and Karma. Krishna does not say Janma Karma Vibhagasha. He says Guna and Karma. Guna and Karma. Karma means actions and Guna means qualities. Okay. So Karma is external and Guna is internal. Okay. So therefore, why is Vishnu specially disposed towards all the Brahmins? Because they are always thinking about the welfare of others. Okay? Especially we know the example of Ambarish Maharaj from Srimad Bhagavatam. He would always feed other Brahmins. He was a Kshatriya, he was a king, but he was like a Brahmana. I mean, he by traits. Internally, he was like a Brahmin, and externally, he was a Kshatriya actually. Same is with Yudhishthir Maharaj. So, therefore, they are always doing activities for the welfare of other people actually. So, therefore, and they are also doing spiritual activities. They are cultivating themselves, you know, they are cultivating others actually. So, that is why Lord Vishnu always is favorably disposed towards the Brahmins, okay. And that is why he is known as the protector of the Brahmins. And there is a shloka which also says, नमो ब्राह्मण्य देवाय गो ब्राह्मण्य हिताय च जगद्धिताय कृष्णाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। राइट, सो देयर मेनी श्लोकास व्हिच सेज दिस, देन अवेयर ऑफ ऑल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ रिलीजन। विष्णु इज द वन हु इज अवेयर ऑफ ऑल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ रिलीजन। व्हाई? बिकॉज देयर इज द फेमस श्लोक इन भागवतम व्हिच सेज धर्मम तु साक्षात भगवत प्रणीतम, व्हिच मीन्स Dharma is defined directly by Lord Vishnu. So anybody who is interested to know what Dharma is, they should read the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. That these two books will tell you what Dharma is. Dharma means what you should do in life. Okay, what should be your disposition? Dharma entitles some set of rules and regulations and prescriptions, prohibitions, what you should do, what you should not do, the do's and don'ts for life, right? So many times, once I met a person, he said, you know, oh, I think according to me, meat eating is not bad. I said, all right, but how does it matter what is good according to you or me? Nothing matters what is good or bad according to you or me. The only thing which matters is what does Lord Vishnu say? All right, so therefore, if we want to know what is right, these days there's a lot of talk on what is right, what is wrong. Nowadays there's this idiotic, stupid idea of, oh, nothing is good, nothing is bad, everything is relative, you know, ye bhi thik hai, wo bhi thik hai. That is sheer epic nonsense, all right? That's total crap. It is totally against the principles of the scriptures, because if that would be true, then Krishna need not speak anything, right? He need not speak the Bhagavad Gita. He could have just not even come. Why does he come? Why does Vishnu take avatar? So that he can, these avatars like Krishna, Ram, Narsingha, Vara and all these, they can teach us what is right and wrong, what we should do. And right and wrong, why? So that we ourselves are happy. So that we can make better choices in life. And then we become better persons ourselves. We do not suffer later. Okay? So that is why he is known as the Sarva Dharmagyam, one who is aware of all principles of religion, one who expands the glory of his devotees. So if you see the Bhagavad Gita's cover, I don't know if it is here, but if you see this photo, you will see Krishna is standing, Arjuna is sitting, but here both are standing. But there is another photo, it's a very famous photo, I wish I could have shown you that, where Arjuna is standing and he is shooting arrows, but Krishna is sitting down. So many times Westerners who are not aware of the Vedic context, Vedic tradition, Vedic culture, they get surprised. Oh, who is this? Oh, is that one standing? Is he God? Is he that Krishna? So, no, he's not standing, he's sitting. So externally, if you see, sometimes his devotees like Arjuna and Yudhishthira, they are more in limelight. So Krishna, by Krishna's grace and his blessings, the Pandavas won the war, of course, with their own efforts also. But Krishna did not sit in the throne. He said, Yudhishthira Maharaj, you must sit in the throne. So Krishna made Yudhishthira famous. Krishna made Arjun famous by protecting Draupadi when Draupadi's Dushasan was trying to disrobe her in front of everybody. Then when Krishna, Draupadi called Krishna, then he came, and by that Draupadi became so famous because that she was so devoted that when she called, Krishna personally came. Okay. So, and everybody, in fact, Kunti also. Then we have Yashoda's example, Krishna's mother. Then we have, I mean, so many examples. I can keep quoting one by one, but it will take a long time. So, therefore, he is the one who also gives fame to his devotees. Because, you know, why is it? It's like electric socket, you know, as I give the example, you know, where when you touch an electric socket, you will get shock, right? So anybody who is in contact with Lord Vishnu, he also gets that shock. Shock means because Vishnu is all famous, therefore they also become famous. Okay, and now you may be thinking, oh, but nobody knows about Krishna in Germany. Nobody knows about Krishna in France. I mean, there are people who know, but not many know. Oh, it seems the film stars and sports people are more famous than Lord Vishnu, right? But the problem is we are only seeing from this realm, this Bhuloka. Okay, so here they may be only known in India. Okay, but the thing is, if you read the scriptures, you will know. They say
यम ब्रह्म वरुणेन्द्र रुद्र मरुत स्तुनवंति दिव्यैस्तव यमराज ब्रह्म रुद्र इंद्र मरुत एवरीबॉडी दे आर डूइंग दिव्य स्तुति स्तुतिगान विच मीन्स दे आर praising in they are chanting divine chants right in praise of Lord Vishnu. So entire 14 planetary worlds within this Brahmand, and then in all the other Brahmands, Lord Vishnu's glories are eternally chanted. Okay, so therefore some people in Germany or France or Brazil or maybe Indonesia or anywhere, or anywhere, you know, in Australia, they may not know who Vishnu is, but they at least know that there is somebody like God. So in that context, you can still say that he is all famous. Okay, so therefore he expands the glory of his devotees, and he is the protector also, as it is said. All right, and as we see in the Mahabharata also, that he always protected Arjuna when this he was about to kill Jayadrath, and then Arjuna had put all himself totally, and then Krishna understood that because all the Kauravas are attacking together, it is not possible for one person to fight with all. It's simply not possible, right? And therefore, Krishna did that Leela where the sun was hidden, and then Jayadrath thought that it's sunset and Arjuna will now submit himself to fire. So he came out, and then suddenly the last rays of the sun appeared, and then Arjuna killed Jayadrath. Okay. So Krishna has always protected his devotees. In any incarnation, he had protected Vibhishan as Narsimha, he protected Prahlad. So therefore, he is the supreme monarch of all planetary systems, full of opulences, and the original father of Brahma, Shiva, and all living entities. Srila Baldev Vidya Bhushan quotes the following verses from Mahabharata, where Krishna explains that he is the source of all living beings. Prajapatim cha rudram chapi aham eva srijami vai tau hi mam na vijanito mam maya vimohito. The patriarchs, Shiva and others are created by me, though they do not know that they are created by me because they are deluded by my illusory energy. Alright, so that's what he is telling. And even that shloka which I was quoting, Yam Brahma Varunindra, in that the end is like Yasyantam Navidusura Surgana Devaya Tasmai Nama, means that even the devatas, they cannot fathom his glories and his endlessness, you know, his divinity. They cannot understand. Yasyantam, anta means end. Navidusura means the suras cannot understand. Tasmai namaha, which means they are offering obeisances to Lord Vishnu. He is so great that even the devatas headed by Yama, Brahma, Shiva, Indra, Maruts, they cannot understand, all right? So therefore, many times we are seeking protection and shelter from government. We are seeking shelter from husband, wife, mother, father, you know, chief minister, prime minister, doctors, astrologers, you know, psychics, life coaches, so many people, you know, like trying to be the savior of humanity. But many times you will realize that nobody can save you. There's only one person who can save you. Who is that? And that is Lord Vishnu himself, all right? And that is why he says that he is the protector. So this verse is very much centered around protection, if you see the theme of this verse. All right. So if you want to feel protected always and sheltered, then you must read the Bhagavatam and the Bhagavad Gita, or you can read the Vishnu Sahasranam. That will give you a sense of protection and security always. All right. Thank you very much for your patience and your time. And if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me, you can always go down to the website down below. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Okay. And if you are interested to watch another video from the Mahabharata, I'll put it here. Right.